This lesson is going to cover radios, and not the ones you think of when you might hear the word radio. When I say radios, I'm referring to Bluetooth, location services, NFC, cellular data, and anything else that gives off a signal. This lesson will be broken up by each type of radio. Let's get into it. If you enjoy Go Incognito and our thorough approach to security, privacy, and anonymity, but you want some more individualized attention and help, we just publicly opened consulting. This is a premium and limited service that can only accommodate a few people. So if you're interested in getting that individual support, we're here to help you out and get you taken care of to fast forward your privacy today. Enjoy this next lesson. To start with Bluetooth, Bluetooth has allowed us to interact with devices wirelessly like never before. Security risks like bluejacking, blue snarfing, and blue bugging have affected every version of Bluetooth except 4.0 and onward, and even the newer versions are vulnerable to eavesdropping through the new Bluetooth low energy tech, and we even saw the blueborn vulnerability in 2017, not to mention the constant new vulnerabilities coming out. As for privacy, Bluetooth is a major component of invasive technologies like contact tracing, as well as methods like tracking individuals in things like retail stores. What can you do about this? First, make sure you're up to date on your devices. Second, utilize proper Bluetooth passwords on devices requiring them, so don't use the default zeros. Third, leave Bluetooth off as much as possible. It doesn't need to be on all day. Lastly, don't use it at all if you can. If you have the option to go wired, go wired. The next radio is GPS. GPS is great for navigation and other situations that require your location, but there are concerns, especially with recent location-based features from Google and Apple. Location data can be used in ways you may not intend, like tracking travel patterns, targeting you for marketing, and location tracking itself is another data point used to build a comprehensive record on your life. We've seen how Uber handled this back in Section 3, Apple got in trouble some time ago for storing GPS data in an unencrypted file, and if you've enabled Google location history, just go look for yourself at how extensive this can be. Additionally, certain apps and programs may publicly reveal your location without your knowledge, opening up the door for stalkers. The last concern is surveillance. Law enforcement agencies can obtain location data through various methods. To add to this, according to a report by the ACLU, law enforcement agents can track innocent people who happen to be in the vicinity of a crime. So this can impact people who do nothing wrong, and they aren't even alerted when their data is snagged. The best thing to do is to not record the data in the first place. First, only grant apps and programs the permission to view your location if it's required. If there's an app that requires a location to function, you can try to fake your location on Android using a location spoofer. Set the location to a random area near you and keep it there at all times. iPhones don't allow location spoofing unless you jailbreak. There are great tweaks if you do decide to go this route. Second, opt out of any location-based tracking and/or personalization on your device. Google and Apple both do this. Third, install a custom ROM like GrapheneOS or CalyxOS on Android devices to cut out most, if not all, Google tracking altogether. Section 4 covered this more thoroughly. Fourth, make sure to disable location sharing in apps like Snapchat and Find My Friends. Fifth, completely disable location services unless you explicitly need to use them. The last and very extreme thing you can do is just turn it off at all times, or you can physically remove the GPS chip in your device. This isn't always possible and every device is different, but the option is there for people willing to go those lengths. It's also important to mention that according to a study by Berkeley, 99.6% of the times that Android accesses location data, the icon isn't visible to the user.
Both iOS and Android have a location indicator, which is illuminated in the status bar whenever an application tries to access the GPS hardware. Unfortunately, on Android, there are actually at least three different other ways of accessing location data. So apps can query cell tower data, they can look at Wi-Fi hotspot information, and they can also look at the location cache. So whenever an app does access GPS hardware, that's cached and is accessible to any other app on the device that has access to the location permission.
NFC is the next radio. NFC is used when you make a payment at a store with your phone. It's also used for things like data transfer between two devices. Let's start with the positives. First, NFC has a short range, requiring devices to be close together, limiting the chance of someone eavesdropping, corrupting, or manipulating the connection. You can read about some of these attacks on this webpage. But, there's always a but, NFC is not perfect. Google, Sprint, and other companies have stated they do not intend to generate revenue by taking cuts from NFC transactions. Instead, they hope to use NFC to provide highly personalized ads and coupons. Likewise, retailers and digital signage companies are considering ways to leverage NFC to deliver marketing tailored to a user's location and preferences. To top it all off, Google and Apple's involvement in payments means your shopping habits are now tied to your Google and Apple account. What do we do? First, disable NFC as often as possible, only enabling it when it's needed. The third option is to leave NFC disabled at all times, never using it for anything. Now, before I reveal the most intrusive and undisclosed form of radio tracking, let's cover some other quick little things to watch out for. Google Nearby is creepy, and it should be clear why I recommend disabling this. Lastly, don't forget to lock your SIM card. This will ensure anyone who gets your SIM will need a password in order to start your cell service and possibly access your contacts. Just a tip. All right, Henry, what's the final radio you need to watch out for? You might be surprised to hear this, but it's Wi-Fi and cellular radios. First, firms like Google and Apple use customer data to compile large databases of cell towers and Wi-Fi access points. But this is kind of the least of our worries here. Simply leaving Wi-Fi enabled on your laptop or phone can be detrimental to your privacy. Snowden revealed that the CSEC can identify travelers passing through Canadian airports by capturing their MAC address. This type of technology can be used anywhere at any time without your knowledge. To dive deeper, your mobile device connects to a series of cellular towers. The closest one handles calls, texts, and internet sessions. As you move, your phone pings other towers to make sure you're still using the best tower. Here's the problem. The data logged from pinging multiple cell towers can geographically pinpoint a user using triangulation techniques from three or more cell towers with extreme accuracy. This was actually a technique used to catch Pat Barbaro in an Australian mafia investigation, despite them using burner phones. Not only are you trusting your cellular provider to properly manage this location data, but law enforcement can and do request this information. As a matter of fact, lots of cell companies were caught selling this location data. If this wasn't alarming enough, law enforcement is known to create devices that pretend to be cellular base stations that intercept voice and text messages when your phone mistakenly connects to it, commonly known as a stingray. These are typically used at large rallies, allowing law enforcement to later identify who was attending the rally. What can we do? First, disable Wi-Fi as much as possible to avoid any tracking done when you're searching for networks. Once you're inside a location with Wi-Fi, then turn it on. Second, and I know it's extreme, try to keep your phone on airplane mode as much as possible or utilize a Faraday bag. If this isn't enough for you, a step up is to leave your phone at home. It can't track where you're going if it's not with you. Although this is getting into the extreme realm. The last thing you can implement is a burner phone, which is legal in the US, but not in every country. Burner phones are a very private option since they don't require a name, address, social security number, or a revealing payment method. Keep in mind that walking into a store means there will likely be cameras, and most forms of transportation are tracked as well. The inconvenience of getting through these problems is astronomical, but you will have close to an anonymous phone if you purchase it properly. This is definitely not for everybody, but the option is there for people who need the absolute highest privacy. However, even if you get a burner phone, it's not directly immune to some of these methods of tracking. It just adds a layer of privacy. And also, there's no encryption, as we mentioned back in section 4. To summarize the lesson, every radio you use creates a new potential security exploit or a potential leak of information about your personal data. I hope this lesson has taught you to think differently about radios, and I'll see you in the next lesson discussing device separation. Thank you for watching.